Hello everybody, welcome to the CSS3 course. In this video, I'm going to talk about the ways to change the styles of hyperlinks. So before I discuss the style changes, I would like to show the web page on the right hand side and the HTML file corresponding to this web page. So for this web page, I just include a number of links. And this first one is this one, corresponding to this link in blue for now. And the second hyperlink corresponds to the second link shown on the HTML file. Now it is purple in color. Then I would like to show you the ways to change the appearance of the links to the button format. So let me show you the hyperlinks for now. I have three links here. The first one is a blank page specified by the hash character. Okay. And the second link is simply a link on to a certain website. And the final link is also a link to a certain website. And since I already visited the third link, I would be able to see that the link is now in purple. And for the first two links, they are now blue because I haven't visited them yet. So now I'm going to show you the ways to change the appearances of all the links. And we are able to change the size of the characters on the link because I already set up the anchor to have a font size which is equal to 2m. So these anchors would have a font size of 2m. Now let me discuss the ways to change the appearances of different states of a hyperlink. So we rely on the pseudo-classes of a given hyperlink. When we specify the states of a hyperlink, we usually need to remember this order. We will start with the link, followed by the visited class, and then I would like to specify the focus class, followed by the hover class, and finally I would specify the active class. So these words will have some particular meanings that I will discuss later. So let us start with the first word called link. The link pseudo class simply means the default state for an unvisited link. So for now, on the right hand side, I have some links in blue. Actually, they are the unvisited links on my web page. So if I want to specify the styles for the unvisited links, I just use the colon followed by the link pseudo class. And before that, I just include the class name called conventional, which is simply this one. Okay. So the class is given on the HTML file already. So the ways to change the appearance of the link can be something like this. I just change the color of the link characters to gray. So if the link is not yet visited, I just have a gray appearance. Okay. And then for the second pseudo class called visited, it means that the link is already recorded in your browser history. So the link in purple for now is the visited link. So I just need to specify the appearance here. So now the link has changed to khaki. So this color represents the visited link. And the third one is called focus. It just represents the link being chosen by pressing the tab key. So what does it mean by that? Let me press the tab key. Before that, I click on the web page. Click. So you see when I simply click on the tab key, I would have a box enclosing the element, which is shown on the right hand side now. So this link is the one being focused. And when I press the tab key again, we see that the second link is now the focused link, okay? So the word focus simply means the one being chosen by the tab key. So how can I change the appearance? I can do something like this. Okay, so when I press the tab key again, I'm able to see that the one being chosen would have a link color in light green, and its background color is simply deep sky blue. So when I press the tab key again, I would have another link being chosen by the tab key. So the link that is chosen now would have a color of light green, and the background color of this link is deep sky blue. Okay. And the fourth state to consider is the hover state. So what does it mean by the word hover? So when I put my cursor on top of a certain link, this action is already called the hovering action. So when I simply put the cursor on top of a link, I have no noticeable changes. So let me do it now. Okay, I set up some styles for the hover state. So when I simply put my cursor on top of the link, I would go to the hover state. So you can see that the background color has changed to orchid, the border width has changed to 10 pixels, and of course the border style is dotted. So this is the state for the hover condition. Okay. And the final one is the active state, which is simply the situation when the link is being clicked on. So for now, when I want to click on this link, I have some particular color changes. Okay. For example, the letters have changed to a bit green, and of course the background border has also changed to green color. Okay. So when I just want to change the active state appearance, I can do something like this. Okay, when I click on this link, you see that the background color has changed to chocolate color. So you see that the appearance of the link being clicked on is already different from the previous situation. Okay. Then I'm going to show you the ways to change the appearance of the links to the button styles. So before doing so, let me go back to the HTML component. So I have just an unordered list having three list items, and for each list item, I just include a hyperlink to a certain web page. Okay. So I'm going to change the list element in this way. Okay, when I set the list elements as having a display of inline mode, I'm able to just combine all the three links to just one row so that they are no longer treated as the block elements. So when I simply say inline here, I'm just going to change the list elements into the inline elements. Okay, so now we are a bit closer to the button appearance. Okay, so let me go to another part. So now I have already specified the classes for the three links. So I just want to change the appearance of this class called button-like. The first thing to do is to change the display mode to inline block. The purpose is like this. If the inline block display mode is set, I'm able to change the width and height of the element. And I'm going to show you the ways to change the dimensions now. Now I have already changed the width and the height of the inline block elements. So you see that the width is a bit wider than before, but now the height is not noticeable. And after my further changes, I'm able to see the height of the inline block elements who have changed to 80 pixels. So let me continue the styling. I changed the font size to 24 pixels. Now you can see that the background color of the inline block elements has changed to green-yellow. And now you're able to see the effect of the width and height attributes. Okay, so the width is 100 pixels and the height is 80 pixels. I also include the padding. I also include the margins. I'm also able to adjust the text inside the inline block elements to the center of each inline block element. Okay, you're able to see that the color of the link has changed to brown. Okay. In addition, I also set up the line height of the words inside the inline block element to be 2. So you can see the increased separation between the box surrounding the word and the word itself. Okay. And then I'm going to change further by simply specifying the hyperlink appearance by using the aforementioned pseudo-classes. So for now, I'm going to change the link pseudo-class. Okay, you see that the unvisited links have changed to dark cyan. Now I'm also able to add the border for my link, okay. Okay, you're able to see that the border has been included surrounding the link, okay. So the border style is groove and the border color is simply dim gray. We can see it a bit easier when I simply click on the HTML file to remove the color of selection. So I'm also able to change the visited state. Now the visited link originally in purple has changed to dark blue. And I'm also able to change the focused state. Okay, so when I simply press the tab key, okay, I'm able to see that the one being focused on has changed to light coral as the background color. So when I press the tab key again, I'm able to focus on another link that is having a light coral color because it is now being focused. Same for the third demonstration. For link 2 here. And then I'm able to change the hover state. How can I change it? I can do something like this now. Okay, when I simply put my cursor on top of one link, I'm able to see the changes controlled by the hover state. The background color has changed to sky blue. The color of the words has changed to white. The border style is not the original one. It is now dotted. And the border color has changed to dark violet instead of the original one, which is dim gray. Okay. The final state to change is the active state. This corresponds to the state when I simply click on the hyperlink. So let me do something now. Okay, when I click on the link, yes, I'm able to see the background color has changed to dark orchid, and the color of the word has changed to light pink. When I release my button, I can click on another one. I'm able to get the same effect as well, which is controlled by the active state of the button-like class. Okay. So this completes the demonstration of the ways to change the hyperlink appearances. The most important thing is to remember the order of the changes, which is shown here. We have to follow this order. The link, the visited state, the focus state, the hover state, and finally the active state. If you don't follow the order in this way, the changes for each of the pseudo-classes may not be able to appear as you expected. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.